morning. Good morning, my brethren. I just want us to thank the covenant keeping God who has been carrying us, who has been watching over us, who has been keeping us, who has been blessing us, who has been providing and meeting our needs. The gift of life we have this morning is because the covenant keeping God has not allowed the devil to kill us. The life we have is because the covenant keeping God has not allowed even our mistakes, even our failures to destroy us. Let's thank him this morning as we come into his presence. Mighty God, I want to thank you. Amongst all the gods with a small g that I've ever heard about on this planet earth, there is none that compares to you. There is no God like you who is a giver that gave his only begotten son so that I could be redeemed from my sins, so that I could be redeemed from the pit of the enemy, so that we could be translated from the kingdom of darkness and brought to the kingdom of the Son of your love. Father, we thank you this morning. You carry us, mighty God, when other people are carrying their gods, when other gods are demanding a sacrifice, they are demanding blood. They are saying, give a goat, give a chicken, give a cow, give even your child, give your wife, give your husband. Other gods are demanding a sacrifice, but you, oh God, have given us a sacrifice. We say thank you. We bless your name this morning, the covenant keeping God, the one who is awesome in power, awesome in greatness, who is great and greatly to be praised. We worship you, oh God. We exalt your name this morning. Thank you for the life and life in abundance. Thank you for the salvation you have given us. Lord, I want to thank you, my life giver. It is in you that we live and move and have our being. The very life we have has come from you. Everything we have has come from you. We want to say thank you, Lord. I want to thank you, mighty God. I want to bless your name. I want to worship and extol your name, for you've done it again this morning, oh God. It is you, Lord, who wakes us up every morning. It is you, Lord, who keeps us. Let's thank him this morning. Bless his name. Look at what you have done, oh God. Limbradasa. You are not a God that I need to feed. You are not a God that wants blood. You are not a God that is asking for my children, my husband, my sisters. You are not a God that is asking for goats and chickens. You are a God who is full of compassion, a God who is full of love, a God who is faithful, a God who is righteous, a God who is holy. We worship you this morning. We extol your name this morning. Thank you, mighty God. You are the source of life. Elohim, we worship you. Elohim, we bless your name. Adonai, we worship you. You are our master. You are our Lord. We worship you, El Elyon, the possessor of the heavens and the earth. We worship you, El Shaddai, the double-breasted God who has met all our needs according to your riches and glory in Christ Jesus. You are a good God. You are Jehovah Nissi, our banner of victory. We worship you. We thank you, Lord. We bow, O God, to the one who is above all powers, above all thrones, above all kings, above all nations, above every principality, power, ruler of darkness, spiritual wickedness in high places. You are above them all. Thank you, mighty God. We worship you this morning. I thank you this morning. I glorify your name this morning, because the reign of darkness has ended and we are in the kingdom of light. Thank you, for your light shines in darkness and darkness cannot comprehend it, because you are a good God. You are a merciful God. You are awesome in power, awesome in glory, awesome, awesome, awesome. Awesome is your name. We thank you, Father. Radadabo se tererebo kura bababa. Mazika lelebo si karadabo shalaba. Masu kerebo kurindariandarebo se kerebo. Mazika lelebo si anderebo kurianda labo seke lenenina mazunterere bakura babasia mizakante lebo kura bababa mashatunde le bakura basia. Thank you, Father. Honor to your name. Honor to your name. Shekele barababasia ragadosia. Thank you, mighty God. I worship you this morning. Thank you, Father. Awesome is your name. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord, that covenant-keeping God. The Bible says in Psalm 119, verse 89, it says, forever, O Lord, your word is settled in heaven. It stands firm
Your word is unchangeable. No matter how many times the enemy tries to delete the word of God in our lives, the word cannot be altered. It cannot be changed. Father, we want to say thank you for every word that you have given to us. For all the promises of God are yea and amen in Christ Jesus. Your word cannot change. Every scripture we read in the place of prayer, every scripture we read in Bible study, every scripture we read in our quiet time, it remains firm and unchangeable. Your word cannot be revoked. It cannot be changed. What you have said is what you have said. It cannot be revoked. And so this morning we come with thanksgiving. We come with praise. We come, Lord, with gratitude, thanking you for your word, which is at work in our lives. Your word that is bringing to pass your purposes. Your word that brings to pass your good mind for us. We say thank you for your word. Thank you, Lord. Every verse, every scripture we will open this morning. Thank you that that word is secured and settled forever. Thank you, covenant keeping God. Thank you that we are under the covenant that has been sealed by the precious blood of your Son, the new covenant, the new testament. Thank you, Father, for this covenant that speaks mercy, that triumphs over judgment this morning. Lord, thank you for the covenant that is bigger than any other covenant. Let's begin to thank God that this covenant that he has with us through the blood of Jesus, this covenant supersedes any other covenant that is trying to speak in our lives. The covenant of the blood of Jesus, it breaks evil covenants, covenants of ancestral spirits, covenants of familiar spirits, covenants of the prince of darkness, covenants of the kingdom of darkness, covenants of witchcraft altars, covenants that are contrary to the truth of God. This morning, the covenant of the blood of Jesus supersedes and nullifies every evil covenant that is trying to speak in our lives. Shalamakura babasiya. Father, evil covenants, I am praying over our young people, our young women, our young men, covenants with the incubus, the succubus, covenants, oh God, with sexual demons. Father, this morning they are broken in the name of Jesus. Covenants with unclean spirits, covenants with demons of lust, covenants with marine spirits and water spirits. Lord, they are broken by the covenant of the blood of Jesus. Every evil covenant, covenants of evil inheritance, they are broken by the covenant of the blood of Jesus. Every evil inheritance is nullified and superseded by the covenant of the blood of Jesus. Let the blood speak. Let the blood speak. Let the blood speak. Robo sokorabashaya, rimazuka labababa, regado sokorabo. None of us will resemble, oh, any family member for evil. In the name of Jesus, every evil covenant that wants to repeat cycles, patterns of frustration, patterns of failure, we say no. By the covenant of the New Testament, evil covenant, you are broken this morning. In the name of Jesus, thank you, Father. In Jesus' name, amen. If we go to Micah 7, from verse 18, the Bible says, who is a God like you? Micah 7, from verse 18. Who is a God like you? Who forgives wickedness and passes over the rebellious acts of the remnant of his possession. When we look at Isaiah 55, the Bible says in verse 7, let the wicked man forsake his own way and the unrighteous man his own thoughts. Let him return to the Lord that he may have compassion and to our God, for he will freely pardon. You know, our definition of wickedness is not the same as God's definition of wickedness. And the Bible says, let the wicked man forsake his own way. Whatever is your own way, whatever is my own way that God regards as wickedness. There may be some ways that we have that we've given ourselves 10 out of 10 and we think we're awesome. And in God's eyes is wickedness. We're going to ask God, Lord, give me the grace to forsake my own way so that the way I follow is your way. And the Bible tells us in Micah 7:19, who is a God like you who forgives wickedness and passes over the rebellious acts of the remnant of his possession? He will not retain his anger forever, but he constantly delights in mercy and loving kindness. We're going to ask God, Lord, show me your mercy. Show me your loving kindness this morning. Forgive me, Lord, of every wickedness. Forgive me of anything that that I've done that is my own way and is not your way. Lord, I forsake my own way this morning and I receive your way in the name of Jesus. It says, let the unrighteous man forsake his own thoughts. There may be some thoughts that I have that God classifies as wicked. Lord, I forsake those thoughts. Anything that I'm thinking, Lord God Almighty, that I'm thinking and is not in agreement with your thinking, Lord, I pray for mercy. I forsake my own way. I forsake my own way. And I receive your way. I receive your way. I receive your way this morning. Let my own way be washed by the blood of Jesus. Wash it away. And let me go with your way in the mighty name of Jesus. You said, Lord, you pass over our rebellion. You do not retain anger forever. You constantly delight in mercy and loving kindness. Lord, I pray this morning that you will have compassion on us. You said in Isaiah 55 verse 7 that you are a God who can have compassion on us. And you will freely pardon. Lord, freely pardon us this morning. Freely pardon us. Show us mercy. Show us loving kindness. In the mighty name of Jesus, I want to think what you want me to think. I want my thoughts to be your thoughts. I want to think like you, Father God. I want to be like you, mighty God. I want to walk in your ways, mighty God. In the mighty name of Jesus, thank you, Father. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. Micah 7 from verse 19, Bible says, he shall again have compassion on us. He will subdue and tread underfoot our wickedness. He will destroy the power of sin. He shall again have compassion on us. He will subdue and destroy the power of sin. He says, yes, God will cast all our sins into the depths of the sea. You shall give truth to the remnants and loving kindness and mercy to us, as you have sworn to our forefathers from the days of old. Let's begin to receive it this morning and say, Lord, thank you this morning that you will once again have compassion on us. Thank you that, Lord, this morning you are subduing and destroying the power of sin over our lives. Thank you for casting all our sins into the depths of the sea, and you are giving us your truth, your loving kindness and your mercy in the name of Jesus. Wherever sin was dominating, thank you that this morning the power of sin is destroyed, the dominion of sin is destroyed, and what rules is the truth of God, the loving kindness of God, the mercy of God, the power of God in the name of Jesus. Thank you for breaking the power of sin in our bloodlines, in our families, Father, in our bloodlines. Let the power of sin be broken. Let the reign of darkness end in our lives. Rabosu kalabo kura babasi. In the mighty name of the Lord Jesus. Shakabo rokoto robosi. Mazika lebrogodosi andarabo kura babababa. Mazukenderebo kura babababa. Mazika lebrogodosotondorobosi. In the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. As we carry on with our prayers of repentance, you know, brethren, I was in the dream and I was speaking to one of my sisters, and my sister was saying, just like Revelation 2 says, blah, blah, blah. And I said to her, that's not what Revelation 2 says. What you are saying is what somebody in your church said about Revelation 2, but that's not what Revelation 2 says. And the scripture she was quoting, it wasn't what the scripture says. Instead, it was something else that had been man-made, like a manufactured doctrine that had nothing to do with what the Bible said in that scripture that she was quoting. And you know, she wouldn't agree with me. And I said, let's open the Bible and let's look at Revelation. Read it and see. That's not what the Bible said. And you know, when I woke up, I was just like, Lord, deliver us from the interpretations of other people's word, you know, what they have taken and they have twisted the word of God. And when you read that scripture in Revelation that she was going to quote, the Bible says in Revelation 2, to the angel of the church in Pergamos, it says, to the angel of the church in Pergamos, these are the words of him who has and wields the sharp two-edged sword. Remember, the word of God is living and powerful. It's sharper than a two-edged sword. the words that come out of Jesus are like a two-edged sword. And he is speaking and said, I know where you dwell, a place where Satan sits enthroned. Yet you are holding fast to my name, and you did not deny my faith, even in the days of Antipas, my faithful witness, who was killed among you where Satan dwells. Imagine you are in church, but Satan is dwelling inside the church. Satan is enthroned in the church, and they are teaching you what the Bible didn't say, and amending the word of God and saying they had a revelation. I want us to pray for ourselves this morning again and pray on behalf of the body of Christ worldwide. We want to say, Lord, we repent of any way we've allowed anybody to twist the word for us. Any way we've accepted the word that was diluted, because the Bible tells us about the Berean Christians. When they heard the word of God, they go and check it out. Some of us are so addicted to some preachers that more than the way, more than how you read the Bible, you listen to them. More than how you read the Bible, you are listening to them. You don't even read the word of God as much as you listen to them. And sometimes they are going in error. They are twisting it a little bit, and you are receiving it hook, line, and sinker. And the Bible says, I know where you dwell, in a place where Satan sits enthroned. We want to pray this morning that, Father, we pray for mercy. Anything that we have received that is not the word of God, we reject it, we repent, and we plead the blood of Jesus. And now let Satan be dethroned in our midst. We refuse for Satan to have a seat where the children of God gather. For where two or three are gathered in the name of Jesus, there you are in the midst of them, Lord. We refuse for Satan to be enthroned anywhere where we are, even in our homes, even in our offices, even in our jobs, even in your business. Satan must not have a seat in the name of Jesus. How does Satan have a seat? Is when we enthrone him. Lord, in the name of Jesus, have mercy upon us this morning. Have mercy upon the church this morning. Regadoso pregedele bakurabasi masukerebo kur. Father, we come by the blood of Jesus. Anytime, Lord, we have accepted the doctrine of man as the doctrine of God, anytime we have accepted what is not of God, what you never said, we've accepted it, Lord. We repent, we renounce it by the blood of Jesus. And Lord, we ask, let the blood of Jesus wash us, oh God, of every defilement, and where the word of God has been changed, wash us, oh God, of the guilt that comes from amending your word. And Lord, wherever in our midst Satan has been enthroned, Satan has been given a seat, Father, we plead the blood of Jesus. We plead the blood of Jesus. Wherever Satan has been given a seat, we plead the blood of Jesus. We pray in the name of Jesus. Let Satan be dethroned this morning. For Jesus reigns. Jesus reigns. Jesus reigns. His name is above all other names. According to Philippians 2, 9 and 10, God has highly exalted Jesus and given him a name above all names. That at the mention of the name of Jesus, every knee must bow, of things in heaven, of things on the earth, of things under the earth. Every tongue must confess Jesus is Lord. Let Jesus rule. Let Jesus reign. Jesus be enthroned. In the mighty name of Jesus. Father God, we pray in every place where we are, we reject the rulership of Satan. Satan, you cannot be enthroned in our midst. You cannot be enthroned in our jobs. You cannot be enthroned in our businesses. You cannot be enthroned in the schools and the colleges and the universities of our children. In the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. Revelation 22, verse 18. The Bible says, I testify and warn everyone who hears the words of the prophecy of this book. Everyone who hears the predictions, the consolations, and the admonitions. If anyone adds anything to them, God will add to him the plagues, the afflictions, the calamities, which are written in this book. And if anyone takes away from the book or distorts the words of the book of this prophecy, God will take away from that one his share from the tree of life and from the holy city, New Jerusalem, which are written in this book. I want us to pray for mercy, that Lord, show us your mercy. Every addition and subtraction to your word, the Bible says it leads to removal from the tree of life. In other words, you lose eternity. You lose your place in heaven. You lose your place in the book of life. Let us pray for mercy. Father, we pray for mercy over every one of us, everyone in the church, everyone around us. Father, in the name of Jesus, every amendment to your word, we are pleading the blood of Jesus and we pray for mercy. Mercy, mercy, mercy. Mercy that prevails over judgment. You are a merciful God. You are a merciful God. Show mercy to the church. Show mercy to your sons and daughters. Show us your mercy, Lord. None of our brothers and sisters in Christ will lose their place in the tree of life. None of us, oh God, will lose our place in the books of heaven. Father, reveal this to everyone around us. Reveal this, oh God. Lord, have mercy. I pray, O Lord, for every sister and brother, every spiritual sister and brother, everyone in the church. Lord God Almighty, let them read the Bible themselves in the name of Jesus. Before they follow what anybody said, they will read it themselves. Lord, none of us will amend your word. Shakaba legadosia, regadoso koria baba baba, irabo shalamasia, mazukerebo kura baba baba. Every seat of Satan in our midst, you are rebuked in the name of Jesus. The Lord rebuke you, Satan. The Lord rebuke you, Satan. The Lord rebuke you, Satan, in the mighty name of the Lord Jesus. Shalamasuka labahan, shelemari barzuka darabasia. In the name of Jesus, thank you, Father. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. In Revelation 2, the Lord tells us about two doctrines that he particularly hates. The first one was the doctrine of the Nicolaitans. The Nicolaitans were the people who are telling people that, look, you can be born again, still sleep around, fornicate, commit sexual sin. It's not a problem because your body is not saved. Are you not a human being? Are you not a human being? Your body can't be saved. It's all right. As long as you know Jesus in the spirit, as long as you love Jesus in your heart, you can just carry on. And so they carried on. And the Lord Jesus said, I hate it. I hate the deeds of the Nicolaitans. He says, repent quickly or I will remove your candlestick out of its place. I want us to plead the blood of Jesus on the church, and I want us to pray and say, Lord, in the church, we repent, oh God, of every sexual sin, and we repent of every doctrine that excuses sexual sin, and every agreement that the church has with the demons of lust, the demons of uncleanness, the demons of fornication, the demons of adultery. Lord, we stand in the place of repentance and we ask for mercy. Let every agreement with unclean spirits be broken. Lord, we are sick and tired of evil in the house of God. We are pleading the blood of Jesus, and we are asking, oh God, separate your children from evil. Separate your children from the doctrine of the Nicolaitans. Separate your children, oh God, from every uncleanness. In the name of Jesus, Lord, where this doctrine has opened the door to evil agendas, we are pleading the blood, pleading the blood. And we rebuke, oh God, the works of the enemy in the church. Every doctrine of the Nicolaitans, we come against you in the name of Jesus. We come against you. We chase you out with the broom of the Spirit. We sweep you out of the church. We sweep you out of the presence of God. In anamosin naribosi kalaba, rogodoso koria bababa, limbradoso bregede. We sweep you out in the name of Jesus. By the blood of Jesus, we separate our sons and daughters from unclean spirits, spirits of lust, spirits of evil, joining up with the incubus and the succubus. We separate incubus, succubus. We chase you away from the church of God. Sex demons, sex addictions. We chase you from the church of God. We break your power over God's children. Lose your hold in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father, in the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you, Lord. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. And then the Bible says, still in Revelation 2, It talks about the doctrine of Balaam. Balaam taught Balak how to put a stumbling block before the sons of Israel, entice them to eat things that have been sacrificed to idols, and to commit sexual immorality. We want to pray. The doctrine of Balaam, it doesn't always work exactly like this in our time, you know, because if they invite you to the temple of their idol, you'll refuse to go. But if they say, oh, it's my 50th, it's my 60th, it's my 40th, come, you will now go and eat their fried rice, jollof rice, fried fish, what sort, without knowing where that went through. Which altar did it go through? Do you know what I'm saying? Or you could be in the dream and they're feeding you food. And that food they're feeding you is witchcraft food. And it's meant to defile, to weaken in the spirit and cause you to be unable to fulfill the mission of God. You want to pray, you fall asleep. You want to read the Bible, you fall asleep. You have the strength to attend every function in the world. But when it's time to go to the things of God, you are tired. You are weary. You can't do it. But if they say, come to party, come to a wedding, you have strength. We want to pray this morning that, Father God, any way that the enemy has put a stumbling block in our spiritual lives, Lord, through eating, through food, through gifts, whatever it is, even in our dreams, Father, we are pleading the blood of Jesus. Purge it out of our system. In the name of Jesus, purge every evil deposit, every evil deposit, satanic injections, satanic implants, anything being implanted into your spirit to weaken you in the spirit realm, to cause you to be weak. Father, in the name of Jesus, I declare Holy Ghost fire, consume every evil planting, every evil food people have received in the dream, in the natural. Let the fire of God destroy it. Let the blood of Jesus purge our systems. Lord, every chain of bondage, evil device, imprisonment of our humanities, implants, physical ones, spiritual ones, energetic implants established against us even while we are sleeping. Oh Lord, in our day-to-day lives, in our jobs, the food they gave us, the money they gave, whatever it is, Father, we plead the blood of Jesus. Let the Holy Ghost fire consume everything that has been planted to weaken, to cause the people of God to be weak. What have you received? Any counterfeit gifts, any evil mandates, evil technologies, fire of God consume them. In the name of Jesus, any food that has connected us to evil altars, Father, we renounce and reject the power of those evil altars. We renounce and reject the power of their sacrifices. Holy Ghost fire, destroy their altars. Destroy any connection to evil altars. Anything they've used to connect us to the evil dimensions and the evil realms. Father, in the name of Jesus, we renounce it. We reject it. In the name of Jesus. Father, we thank you. In Jesus' name. Amen. I was hearing the testimony of a young woman who was in school and somebody gave a meat pie and a drink. And when she ate that meat pie and drink that night, she had a dream that she appeared under the sea, under the ocean, and met the queen of the coast, and all the people around the queen of the coast. And she saw that person who gave her the meat pie in the meeting, and they said, welcome, daughter. She had no power to resist when they summoned her. She couldn't even say, no, thank you. I don't want to come under the ocean. She had no power because she ate the meat pie. The meat pie was their link to summon her. Are you with me, child of God? Sometimes people give you something, and then that night you go to bed, you have one strange dream. You say, ah, blood of Jesus, I cancel the dream. But you don't understand that thing that they gave you has become a connector to an evil altar. And now they are able to call your name, call you, summon you, and all sorts. We want to pray this morning that by the blood of Jesus, Lord, I break every connection to evil altars. I break it. Holy Ghost fire, destroy satanic umbilical cords that connect me, my spouse, my children, to evil altars. all the satanic umbilical cords that are connecting us to evil agendas, evil altars, satanic umbilical cord. The person becomes helpless. They summon them. They say, come here. And they come. Roko sukaraba shalabasi. Lord, we break that connection. We break that evil umbilical cord. In the name of Jesus, Holy Ghost fire, destroy them. Shakabare gadosia. Rabosia. We reject the doctrines of Balaam. We reject it, oh Lord. Rebosi kalabahanda. In the name of Jesus. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. I was speaking to some people. One of our daughters, she said, oh, you know, she's in the place of prayer. She's fasting and all sorts. Then she goes to bed. In the dream, she'll be raped. What happened? I've been praying. I'm being raped. And then she goes back to sleep. And a woman will rape her. Lesbian sex. A man will rape her. All sorts of things. A relative will rape her. Incest. Like, what's going on? It's because they are connecting you to evil altars. Something is saying you cannot live a clean life. You cannot be righteous. You are connected to the incubus and the succubus and the water spirits. The marine spirits are saying we are connecting you. I spoke to somebody. They said they had a dream. In the dream, this dream recurs. They always see naked women. And the naked woman will offer them their breast and say, come and suck breast. You see, they are connecting them to an evil altar. I want us to pray this morning. This is the doctrine of Balaam. It is a doctrine that says you are trying to live a holy life. That son, that daughter is trying to live a holy life. And the enemy is saying, no, you are connected to evil altars. I want us to pray this morning. The Bible tells us in the book of Revelation 5:5, Revelation 5:5, when the revelator was weeping and saying, what are we going to do? The earth is under the control of Satan. One of the 24 elders saying, stop weeping. Stop crying. Look closely. The lion of the tribe of Judah, the root of David, has overcome. He has conquered. He can open the scroll and break its seals. He has overcome. He has conquered. And it says in verse 9 of Revelation 5, he is worthy and deserving to take the scroll and break its seals. The scroll represents the title deeds of the earth. It says, because with your blood, you purchased people for God from every tribe and language and people and nation. You have made them a kingdom of kings and priests. The lion of the tribe of Judah has prevailed. Every altar that is trying to connect you, you are trying to be free, free from the disease, free from the affliction and the diagnosis. And they are still trying to connect you to the altar of premature death. The lion of the tribe of Judah has prevailed. You're going to speak his name and say, the lion of the tribe of Judah has prevailed in my life, has prevailed in our family. Everything that is trying to connect us to evil altars, we declare our freedom this morning. Colossians 1 and 13, it says the Father has rescued us and drawn us to himself from the dominion of darkness and transferred us to the kingdom of his beloved Son, in whom we have redemption because of his sacrifice, resulting in the forgiveness of sins and the cancellation of sins penalty. You evil altar, lose your hold. Begin to speak this morning. You evil altar, lose your hold over my life. In the mighty name of the Lord Jesus, every evil altar that is trying to connect you to evil, every time you try to be free, they call you back. They join you through dreams, through evil spirit food, through incantations, through spells, through enchantments, through hexes and vexes and hoaxes, through any ritual, whatever is the ritual connecting you to evil. In the name of Jesus, we cut them off this morning. We cut them off. We renounce and break the power of all the sacrifices and rituals performed on evil altars. We renounce and break the power of every evil altar. We declare in the name of Jesus, they have no impact over us, our spouse, our children, our children's children. Every evil thing that is being done to summon people to altars of wickedness, you're gonna pray. What is the point of contact they have of you?
Whatever it is, your photograph, your name, your handwriting, rakasikala, pieces of your DNA, whatever they have on their evil altar, let it catch fire. Let it catch fire in the mighty name of Jesus. Some people have fornicated and they didn't know that their body fluids were harvested by snakes and put on evil altars. Father Lord, that sperm on that evil altar, let it catch fire. That fluid from that woman on that evil altar, let it catch fire in the name of Jesus. Everything they are using, DNA, your spit, your cells, your hair, your pictures, your nails, whatever, let it catch fire in the name of Jesus. Catch fire. We renounce and reject evil agendas in the name of Jesus. We refuse to agree with them. The doctrine of Balaam will not prevail against any of us in the name of Jesus. Evil connectors, you are frustrated and destroyed. Evil connectors, you are frustrated and destroyed in the mighty name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. Finally, in Revelation 2, it talks about Jezebel. The spirit of witchcraft, spirit of manipulation and control. You're going to plead the blood of Jesus and say, Lord, I separate myself from the outworkings of the Jezebel spirit. I cut that principality off by the blood of Jesus. Wherever Jezebel is trying to manipulate and control my life, my spouse, my children, my children's children, my brothers and sisters in Christ, I separate from you. Jezebel, I refuse for you to manipulate and control any of us in the name of Jesus. You spirit of witchcraft, you are rebuked in the name of Jesus. We rebuke witchcraft. We rebuke it. We reject it. We renounce it. The enchantment of Jezebel, you are broken by the power in the name of Jesus. The incantations of Jezebel, you are broken by the power in the name of Jesus. The sorcery, the rituals, the hexes and the vexes and the hoaxes, the threats, every way Jezebel has been threatening, Lord, we shut down those threats by the power in the name of Jesus. Jezebel, you are rebuked. In the name of Jesus, you are rebuked. In the name of Jesus, you are rebuked. Ragadoso bregedede bosikalaba. Evil prophecies. Jezebel comes with evil prophecy, evil prophetic prayers, evil pronouncements. We cancel all of you by the blood of Jesus. Everything that has been done, evil prayers that they are praying against us, we cancel by the blood of Jesus. Evil decrees, we break them by the blood of Jesus. Evil pronouncements, we revoke them by the blood of Jesus. Shakabalegadosia. Shakabalegadosia. Jeketelebokurababasia. Marogodo sokoria baba baba baba. Jala bobo 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 kurabasia. Regede sekelebosia. Makura babasia ndelebosia. Mira bobo bobo bosia ndelebosia. Merika senderebosia. In the name of Jesus, Jezebel, you are rebuked. Radoso bregetedeba, limbasu kalaba. Father, every veil, every scale, covering our understanding, enabling Satan and his agents to be victorious, let the veils and the scales be removed. For 2 Corinthians 3:18 says, but we all with open face, beholding as in a glass the glory of the Lord, we are being transfigured into the same image as by the Spirit of the Lord from glory to glory. Remove the veils and the scales. Bible says in that 2 Corinthians 3:17, where the Spirit of the Lord is, there is liberty. Lord, we speak liberty. Liberty in our lives. Freedom from satanic agendas, satanic oppressions, principalities, powers, rulers of darkness, spiritual wickedness in high places, familial spirits, ordinances of wickedness, evil inheritance. We receive freedom. For where the Spirit of the Lord is, there is liberty. There is liberty. Shakaboriba sikaraba. Jeketelebosia. In the mighty name of Jesus. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Brethren, you know, I was in the dream. I saw this woman. This woman, this pastor's wife and her daughter. And they were eating evil food. She was bringing her children and they were buying this evil food and eating it. And in the dream, I was trying to help them. You know, they wouldn't be helped. And when I woke up, I remembered that some months ago, God gave me a word for this woman, for her daughter, you know.
And I remembered years ago, before I had my daughter Jemima, I was in a conference, a minister's conference, and there was a deaconess behind me. She tapped my shoulder and said, "Pastor, I am seeing your children next to you. They are lifting up their hands. They say, 'Mommy, mommy, pick me up.'" And I said, "I can't see them. But if you can see them, if God opened your eyes to see this for me, then I know you're not a witch. You're a child of God. I accept it. Lord, I pick up my children." And do you know what? My daughter's pregnancy was dated to that weekend, even though I never had any sexual relationship or whatever in that month. But God knows how to work things miraculously through people's word. God sends people. God sent that deaconess to me. I accepted the word. God sent me to this woman. She refused the word. I want you to pray for yourself, child of God. There are people God assigns to our lives to be a blessing. I want you to pray for yourself. You know, we are in the midst of spiritual warfare. God can speak through a baby. They don't have to be a senior pastor or a senior prophet to see what will help you. I want you to pray for yourself and say, "Lord, in this season of spiritual warfare, give me the discernment to discern my helpers. I will not, oh God, chase them away. When the word comes from the people you have sent to me, I will receive it. In the name of Jesus, I will receive it. I will not remain a prisoner because of pride. Because I said, who do they think they are?" Begin to lift up your voice and pray. In the name of Jesus, Father God, in this season of spiritual warfare, I receive the word of God. Every true prophet that you have sent my way, every true prophet that you have sent to me, Lord, give me the discerning spirit to receive them. In the name of Jesus, I will not walk in pride. I will not walk in ignorance. In the mighty name of the Lord Jesus, wherever your true prophets are, Lord, let them arise. Let them arise. Let them arise and hear what you have in store for me. In the name of Jesus. And as they come to me, I receive the discerning of spirits to receive them. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Lord, we pray for all those who have missed their messages because they chased away the prophet. Lord, we pray for mercy over them. I pray for mercy. Mercy, Lord, mercy. Everyone who is eating at the table of Satan this morning, Lord, we pray for them. Bring them back. Turn them around. Open their eyes. They are eating from Satan's table and it is destroying their lives. Father, turn them away. In the name of Jesus, we pray, oh God, anyone swallowing wrong doctrine, Father God, open their eyes and remove them from the table of wickedness. In the mighty name of Jesus, we pray for deliverance for everyone around us, brothers, sisters, relatives, neighbors, Lord God Almighty, people around us, all those that the God of this world has blinded. Father, open their eyes. Let there be a deliverance in the mighty name of the Lord Jesus. Child of God, as I round up, I want you to cover yourself and everything that concerns you in the blood of Jesus. Begin to declare, "The blood of Jesus covers me, covers my home, my family, my spouse, my children, my children's children, my house, my car, my bank accounts, everything under my stewardship, my desk at work, the computer I work on, my library at work, everything I have, I cover in the blood of Jesus." Lord, everything, blood of Jesus, begin to speak. My body is blessed. My soul is blessed. My spirit is blessed. In the name of Jesus, I release the anointing of the Holy Spirit over every one of us this morning. We are anointed. We are appointed for such a time as this. In the name of Jesus, and the angels of the Lord are at work in our lives. They will never keep quiet. They will never stop their assignments because God has assigned them. In the mighty name of Jesus, Shakalabosia, in the name of Jesus, in Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. Finally, before we close, I want to leave us with this scripture. We were using it to pray last night. It's still upon my heart. Revelation 5:11. The Bible says, "I looked and I heard the voice of many angels around the throne." Many angels. Angels of God outnumber the voices of the fallen angels. They outnumber the kingdom of darkness, the witches, the wizards, the sorcerers, the warlocks. They outnumber them. It says there were the voices of many angels around the throne. There were the voices of the living creatures, the voices of the 24 elders, the voices of The 10,000 times 10,000 and thousands of thousands, innumerable, infinity, company of voices speaking from the heavenly realms. As we go today, I want you to believe it, that wherever I go, the voices that are against me are less than the voices for me. The voices of God are speaking. The voices from the kingdom of God are speaking. Therefore, we are blessed and highly favored. I want you to thank God this morning that, Lord, I thank you that the voices that are emanating from your throne room are more than those that are against me. There are more on my side than the ones against me. Therefore, this morning, I prevail by the voices emanating from the throne of God. I prevail by the voices coming out of Mount Zion. Every voice speaking against me is drowned out by the voices that are coming from the kingdom of heaven. The voice of the blood of Jesus silences every other voice in the mighty name of the Lord Jesus. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen and amen.